أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear student, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Today, we will discuss binary solid solution of course Inorganic Material Chemistry course code CAM 3115 and this is our 6th lecture. Binary solid solution. The key concept of this topic which we will discuss are terminology, different types of solid solution, Hamme Rothery rules, alloys, classification of alloys, sterling silver, brass and different types of brass, application of solid solution, difference between alloys and solid solutions. Terminology involved in this topic. First, solvent. Solvent in an alloy, the element or compound present in greater amount. Solute in an alloy, the element or compound present in lesser amount. For example, sterling silver, which is composed of 92.5% silver and 7.5% copper. Second phase, as solute atoms are added, new compounds or structures are formed. Our solute form local precipitates. What is solubility limit? Solubility limit of a component in a phase is the maximum amount of the component that can be dissolved in it. For example, alcohol has unlimited solubility in water, sugar has a limited solubility, oil is virtually insoluble. The same concept apply to solid phases. Copper and nickel are mutually soluble in any amount, unlimited solid solubility, while carbon has a limited solubility in iron. Whether the addition of impurities results in formation of solid solution or second phase depend upon the nature of the impurities, their concentration, temperature and pressure. What is solids? Solids are the chemical substances which are characterized by definite shape and volume, low compressibility, and their particles are closely packed by strong forces. And now, what is solution? A solution in thermodynamics refers to a system with more than one chemical component that is mixed homogeneously at the molecular level. Solution may be liquid solution, solid solution, or vapor solutions. Solid solutions are made of host which dissolves the minor component, that is solute. The ability to dissolve is called solubility. When two metals are mixed together, they form an alloy. If one metal is soluble in the other one in solid state, therefore, an alloy is a solid solution of two or more metal. A solid solution is formed when two metals are completely soluble in liquid state as well as in solid state. In other words, when homogeneous mixture of two or more kind of atom or metal occur in solid state, they are known as solid solution. The more abundant atomic form is referred as solvent and the less abundant atomic form is referred as solute. A solid solution defect can be intrinsic if they are associated with stoichiometric dopant, extrinsic if they are associated with dopant or impurities. In the parent lattice, the dopant concentration rises above 0.1 to 1%. It is the common practice to refer to the material as solid solution. Examples: Stirling silver, 92.5% is silver and the remaining is copper, that is 7.5%, is a solid solution of silver and copper. In this case, silver atom are solvent atoms, whereas copper atom are solute atom. Another example is brass. Brass is a solid solution of copper, that is 64%, and zinc 36%. In this case, copper atom are solvent atom, whereas zinc atom are solute atom. Similarly, the ruby, natural gemstone, is also an example of solid solution in which white color of corundum is changed into red color of ruby gemstone. Characteristic: homogeneous, maintain crystal structure, contain randomly dispersed impurities that are substitutional or interstitial. Now, what are binary solid solutions? Many materials are similar enough in their crystal lattice structures that they can mingle freely on the atomic scale. Metal alloys are their common examples. Types of solid solution. Solid solution, such a mixture is considered as solution rather than a compound when the crystal structure of the solvent remain unchanged by addition of the solutes and when the mixture remains in a single homogeneous phase. The solute may incorporate into the solvent crystal lattice substitutionally by replacing a solvent particle in the lattice, interstitially by fitting into the space between solvent particles. Effect on properties. Both of these type of solid solution affect the properties of the material by distorting the crystal lattice and disrupting the physical and electrical homogeneity of the solvent material. Substitutional solid solution. If the atom of the solvent or parent metal are replaced in the crystal lattice by atoms of the solute metal, then the solid solution are known as substitutional solid solution. In the substitutional solid solution, the arrangement of the solute atom, that is the substitution, can be either disordered or ordered. For example, copper atom may substitute for nickel atom without disturbing the face center cubic structure of nickel, as shown in following figure A. Figure B show distorted substitutional solid solution. Here the solute atom have substituted disorderly for the solvent atom on their lattice side. Figure C shows an ordered substitutional solid solution. Here the solute atom have substituted in an orderly manner for the solvent atom on their later side. In addition to provide a simple example of substitutional solid solution, the aluminium oxide chromium oxide system provide a dramatic example of how particle may change on doping or solid solution formation. Aluminium oxide is a white insulating solid with small amount, less than 1% of chromium. Substituting for aluminium, the color becomes bright red. This is the composition of the ruby gemstone and was the material in which the principle of laser action was first demonstrated. What a dramatic effect such a small amount of impurity has. This is compounded by the fact that the ruby red color is lost if too much chromium is added. The solid solution then revert to the green color of Cr2O3. Here is visual explanation of solid solution as shown in the diagram. Interstitial solid solution. In interstitial solid solution, the solute atom does not displace a solvent atom, but rather it enters one of the hole or interstices between the solvent atom. Similar to Homme-Rothery rules can be applied for interstitial solid solution. Interstitial solid solution are formed if a solute is smaller than pores in the lattice of a solvent. A solute has approximately the same electronegativity as a solvent. There are very few elements that create ions small enough to fit in interstitial position. Therefore, applicable solubility is rare for interstitial solid solutions. Ions that often may be a solute in solid solution are hydrogen, lithium, sodium, boron. Most interstitial solid solutions have a strong tendency to spontaneous ordering. Examples of order are partially interstitial solid solution, palladium hydride, aluminium lithium, beryllium lithium. And excellent example is iron carbon steel as shown in following figure. In this system, the carbon, that is solute atom, occupies an interstitial position between iron atom. Normally, atom which have atomic radii less than 1 angstrom are likely to form interstitial solid solution. Examples are atom of carbon 0.77 angstrom, nitrogen 0.71 angstrom, hydrogen 0.46 angstrom, oxygen 0.60 angstrom. Here is visual diagram of interstitial solid solution. What are Homme-Rothery rule? Are conditions for the formation of solid solution. The Homme-Rothery rules are a set of basic rules describing the condition under which an element could dissolve in a metal, forming a solid solution. Some alloy system exhibit complete solid solubility, that is copper nickel or cadmium magnesium. Others show only limited solubility at any temperature. There are two set of rules or factor determining the limits of solubility. one which refer to substitution solid solution and another which refer to interstitial solid solution. These are expressed as a series of rules often called William-Homme-Rodri rules. These are rules for substitution solid solution. First, substitution solid solution in accordance with Homme-Rodri rules may form if the solute and solvent have, first, crystal structure factor. The crystal structure of solute and solvent must match. For example, solid solubility. The two elements should have the same type of crystal structure, that is, both elements should have either face center cubic or body center cubic or hexagonal close packed structure. In considering whether solid solution form, an important factor is the crystal structure of the two end member. In systems that exhibit complete solid solution, it is essential that the end member be isostructural. The reverse is not necessarily true, however, and just because two faces are isostructural, it does not follow that they will form solid solution with each other. For example, lithium fluoride and calcium oxide both have the rock salt structure, but they do not form solid solution. While complete ranges of solid solution form in favorable cases, as between aluminium oxide and chromium oxide, it is far more common to have partial or limited ranges of solid solution. In such cases, the end member need not be isostructural. For example, Mg2SiO4, fosterite and olivine, and Zn2SiO4, willemite, can dissolve about 20% of each other in solid solution formation, even though their crystal structures are different. In the fosterite solid solution of formula Mg2-XZnXSiO4, some of the octahedrally coordinated magnesium ions are replaced by zinc ion. In the willemite solid solution, on the other hand of formula, Zn2-XMgXSiO4, magnesium ion substitute partially for the tetrahedrally coordinated zinc ions. Such solid solutions are possible because magnesium and zinc are of similar size and are happy in both tetrahedral and octahedral coordination. Homme-Rodri rule 2, relative valence factor. A metal will dissolve a metal of higher valency to a greater extent than one of lower valency. Metal with lower valency will tend to dissolve metal with higher valency. The solute and solvent atom should typically have the same valence in order to achieve maximum solubility. Maximum solubility occurs when the solvent and solute have the almost same valency. For example, in aluminium nickel alloy system, lower valency nickel dissolve 5% aluminium, but higher valency aluminium dissolve only 0.04% nickel. Rule 3. relative atomic size factor, the atomic radii of the solute and solvent atom must differ by no more than 15%. As the size, that is atomic radii, difference between two elements increases, the solid solubility becomes more restricted. Extensive substitutional solid solution occurs only if the relative difference between the atomic diameters or radii of the two species is less than 15%. If the difference greater than 15%, the solubility is limited. For example, silver and lead system. Both silver and lead have face center cubic structure and the relative size factor is about 20%. Therefore, the solubility of lead in solid silver is about 1.5% and the solubility of silver in solid lead is about 0.1%. Next is copper and nickel system. Copper and nickel are completely soluble in each other in all proportion. They have the same type of crystal structure, that is face centered cubic, and differ in atomic radii by about 2%. Comparing the atomic radii of solids that form solid solution, the empirical rule given by Homme-Rodri rule is given as in the formula. Let's now see examples of ions which can and cannot replace each other in solid solution formation. We need a constituent set of radii in order to make comparisons using Shannon and Previt radii for octahedral coordination. Based on an oxide ion radius of 1.26 angstrom, monovalent alkali metal and silver ions have radii lithium 0.88 angstrom, sodium 1.16 angstrom, silver 1.29 angstrom, potassium 1.52 angstrom, rubidium 1.63 angstrom and cesium 1.84 angstrom. The radii of potassium rubidium and rubidium cesium pairs are both within 15% of each other, and it is common to obtain solid solution between, say, pairs of corresponding rubidium cesium salts. Sodium potassium salts sometimes form solid solution with each other, especially at high temperature. For example, potassium chloride and sodium chloride at 600 degree, and the potassium ion is approximate 30% larger than sodium ion. The difference in size of lithium and potassium ion is too large, however, these ions do not generally replace each other in solid solution. The silver ion is similar in size to sodium ion, and solid solution between pairs of corresponding sodium silver salt are common. Homme-Rodri rule 4. Chemical affinity factor. Solid solubility is favored when the two metals have lesser chemical affinity. If the chemical affinity of the two metal is greater, then greater is the tendency toward compound formation. Generally, if the two metal are separated in the periodic table widely, then they possess greater chemical affinity and are very likely to form some type of compound instead of solid solution. Next, rule is electronegativity factor. Electronegativity difference close to zero gives maximum solubility. The solute and solvent should have similar electronegativity. If the electronegativity difference is too great, the metal will tend to form intermetallic compound instead of solid solution. The more electropositive one element and the more electronegative the other, the greater is the likelihood that they will form an intermetallic compound instead of a substitutional solid solution. The solute and the solvent should lie relatively close in the electrochemical series. Now, rules for interstitial solid solution. For interstitial solid solution, the Hamme-Rodri rules are: solute atom must be smaller than the pores in the solvent lattice. The solute and solvent should have similar electronegativity. What is corundum? It is a rock forming mineral that is found in metamorphic and sedimentary rocks. Corundum is crystalline form of aluminium oxide, typically containing traces of iron, titanium, vanadium, and chromium, and a hexagonal crystal structure. It is a naturally transparent material but can have different colors when impurities are present. Naturally transparent, but when impurities present like iron, titanium, vanadium, and chromium, color changes. Depending upon the metal present as impurities. This is the structure of corundum, crystalline form of aluminium oxide. What are intermetallic compounds? Intermetallic compounds are generally formed when one metal, for example, magnesium, has chemical properties which are strongly metallic and the other metal, for example, antimony, tin or bismuth, has chemical properties which are only weakly metallic. Examples of intermetallic compound are magnesium, tin, magnesium, lead, magnesium, antimony, and magnesium bismuth. These intermetallic compounds have higher melting point than either of the parent metal. This higher melting point indicates the high strength of the chemical bond in intermetallic compounds. What is olivine? Olivine is a name for series of minerals with the formula M2SiO4, where M is most commonly iron or magnesium. Pyrolite Fe2SiO4 and phosphorite Mg2SiO4 form a substitution solid solution, where the iron and magnesium atoms can be substituted for each other without significantly changing the crystal structure. As there is a size mismatch of only about 7% between magnesium ions and iron ion, so complete solid solution between these two elements is observed in olivine. And now, what are alloys? An alloy is a mixture of metal or a mixture of a metal and another element. Alloy are metallic compound composed of one metal and one or more metal or non-metal element. Alloy are defined by metallic bonding character. An alloy may be a solid solution of metal element, a single phase, or a mixture of metallic phases, two or more solutions. Intermetallic compounds are alloys with a defined stoichiometry and crystal structure. Alloys are used in a wide variety of applications. In some cases, a combination of metal may reduce the overall cost of the material while preserving important properties. In other cases, the combination of metals impart synergistic properties to the constituent metal element, such as corrosion resistance or chemical strength. Examples of alloy are steel, solder, brass, pitwer, duralum, bronze and amalgams. Now the classification of alloys. Alloys are usually classified as substitutional alloys. The solute substitute the solvent in the crystal lattice without structure changes. Interstitial alloys. The solute does not occupy the site in the lattice of the solvent but reside in crystallographic pores. Transformational alloys. A completely new lattice is formed, usually occur as a result of intermetallic compound formation. Different atomic mechanism of alloy formation. Showing pure metal. Substitutional alloy, interstitial alloy, and a combination of substitutional interstitial alloy. And now, what is sterling silver? Sterling silver is an alloy of silver containing 92.5% by weight of silver and 7.5% by weight of other metal, usually copper. The sterling silver standard has a minimum fineness of 925. Fine silver, for example 99.9% pure silver, is generally too short for producing functional object. Therefore, the silver is usually alloyed with copper to give a strength while preserving the ductility and appearance of the precious metal. Other metal can replace the copper, usually with the intention of improving various properties of the basic sterling alloy, such as reducing casting porosity, eliminating fire scale, and increasing resistance to tarnish. These replacement metal include germanium, zinc, and platinum, as well as a variety of other additives including silicon and boron. Alloy such as argentum silver have appeared in recent decades. And what are the uses of alloy? Individual heating implement often included fork, spoons, knives. These are the uses of alloys. A different type of forks, spoons, knives, as shown in the diagrams. What is brass? Brass is a metal alloy made of copper and zinc. The proportion of zinc and copper can be varied to create a range of processes with varying properties. It is a substitutional alloy. Atoms of the two constituents may replace each other within the same crystal structure. By comparison, bronze is principally an alloy of copper and tin. However, bronze and brass may also include small proportion of a range of other elements, including arsenic, phosphorus, aluminium, manganese, and silicon. And what are the uses of brass? Brass is used for decoration for its bright gold-like appearance, for application where low friction is required, such as lock, gears, bearing, doorknob, for plumbing and electrical application, and extensively in brass musical instruments such as horn and bell, where a combination of high workability and durability is desired. It is also used in zipper. These are the different types of brass. First is alpha brasses, in which copper is greater than 65% and zinc is less than 35%. And alpha beta brasses, 55 to 65% copper and 35 to 45% zinc. Beta brasses, 50 to 55% copper and 45 to 50% zinc. Gamma brasses, 33 to 39% copper and 61 to 67% zinc. White brass, less than 50% copper and greater than 50% zinc. Application of binary solid solution. Solid solution have wide range application in various levels, such as nanostructure level, already discussed in alloys. Micro level, solid solution at micro level are studied in the form of strength of metal and ceramics. Local level, at local level, optical properties of Rabi are studied. Rabi is the basic cutting tool for various machineries. Unit cell average structure. At unit cell average structure in the form of cement and glass and steel properties, the whole of our construction industry, transport industry rest upon this. Different beautiful colors, resins and jewelries all are the example of the solid solution. Now, difference between alloys and solid solution. Alloy. First, an alloy is a mixture of metal or a mixture of a metal and another element. And in case of solid solution, a solid solution is a solid state solution of two or more solute in a solvent. Alloys are defined by a metallic bonding character. An alloy may be a solid solution of metal element, a single phase, or a mixture of metallic phases, two or more solution. Solid solution, such a mixture is considered a solution rather than a compound when the crystal structure of the solvent remains unchanged by addition of the solute and when the mixture remains in a single homogeneous phase. In case of alloy, intermetallic compounds are alloys with the defined stoichiometry and crystal structure. And in case of solid solution, this often happens when the two elements, generally metal, involved are close together on the periodic table. Examples of alloys are steel, brass, pitwer, duralum, bronze and amalgam. And examples of solid solutions are crystallized salt with their liquid mixture, moist solid, etc. Student, these are the assignment. What is the formula of halite? First, second, what is the formula of orsiterite? And what is the formula of willemite? Dear student, if you have any question, you can send me your question 24/7 at my email ID maslamchemist@hotmail.com. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.